What's going on, guys? Today, me and Kelsey are going to get together and hit some bench press for y'all. Before we get started, I'm 4 subs away from 200 right now. So if you're new and you're watching this video, if you enjoy it, please hit the subscribe button and help me reach that goal of 200. And also, if we could get 20 likes on this video, that would be great. But anyways, I'm going to go in here today, probably hit close grip on the bench. If y'all seen from my last video, I've been changing up the way I'm training. I'm going to go a little bit more volume. Might go a little heavy today just to maintain a little bit of strength, but nothing crazy. But I'm gonna do close grip. It's a little bit harder, and it's gonna test my strength a little bit more instead of trying to shorten that range of motion with the wider grip. But she also wants me to try some new pre-workout today, some cage pre-workout. So I'm gonna meet up with her when we get to the gym, see what this pre-workout's about, and then we will get in and hit a good chest workout for y'all. One of the main reasons I got away from the heavy lifting for a little while, or decided to, other than the heat and just not being able to gain much weight, you know, or keep it on as much during the summer, was because, especially on bench press and squat, whenever I'm holding the bar back like that, I've been getting like really bad pain in my elbow all the way through my forearms, and sometimes it even comes up to my shoulder right here. And it's bearable. I can keep pushing, but it's just so uncomfortable, and it's very discouraging. Like when you get on the bench press every time, and something like that just pops up, and it just ruins it for you, basically, because you cannot do as much as you want to, or as many reps as you want, regardless if you're doing volume or heavy. It's just gonna get aggravated, and so that's another reason why I decided to step away from the heavy lifting. And I've noticed I've only bench pressed on the free weight maybe twice in the last 2 weeks, and both times I didn't go very heavy at all. But I did do the Smith machine the other day for my last chest day that I posted, and the control, how well I was able to control the weight, I didn't feel no pain at all in my elbow. I didn't have to bounce it none on my chest, you know, when you try to get a little bit of momentum on the regular bench press. It felt really good overall, so that's another reason I felt a lot better with this eating and training a little bit different. I haven't put so much stress on my body. And also with deadlifting, I went to go deadlift at Zoo Culture the other week. And aside from it being so hot in there, my knees just started hurting automatically, and I was like, nah, I'm not doing this today. So that's one reason why I got away from it as well. So I just want to let y'all know that. But now I'm going to head over to the gym. I got these Beats the other day. They're a lot better than my $20 headphones I was using. But the $20 headphones work great too, but these have the noise cancellation in them, so everything's very quiet regardless if I'm playing music or not. It's a lot more easier to stay in the zone. I can't hear that terrible music they're playing in Fitness World all the time. But it's going to be a good workout today. I'm ready for it, ready to see what I can do. If I end up going heavy on the bench, I'll probably wear some sleeves just to help my elbow a little bit in case it starts wanting to hurt. But we'll see what happens when we get in there. So let's go.
Me and you on the bench.
I met up with the crackheads.
Yeah, for real.
All right, chill. This is cool on YouTube. Where's that pre-workout?
Cage.
It might as well be called a crack.
It works.
Let me see what this is.
Real proud of that drink.
388 milligrams of caffeine. I'm definitely not taking all of that.
I took half.
I'm gonna take half a scoop. Damn, you can't even get the caffeine out the cup.
That's
like a daggone cup. Hold on. That's no way. No way I'm taking a whole cup of that.
Oh, God.
All right, hold on. Let me get my drink out.
Look at me double vlogging right now. Look at this.
That ain't no way, man. If somebody told me to take a whole scoop of that, that's like asking for death.
I haven't dry scooped it. Is it sour?
You haven't dry scooped it?
No, I've just been mixing it with water. Is it sour?
I hope I don't pass out.
already sweating.
It don't really have a flavor. It's not sour. Man.
All right, I'm gonna hit some warm up on the tread on the bike real quick, and then we're gonna go over and get straight into the bench press.
Let's go. Make sure you like and subscribe.
He left a week after I got back because I got back home.
No. It was coincidence. But, hey, listen, this dude's away for 5 subs. Let's get him there, baby. His content's great. Let's go.
Oh, appreciate it, man. Somebody today. I really appreciate you watching. Tell them about your bench press session today.
So last week I came in here and tried to bench 120.
Oh, so it was last week.
It was last week.
I told you it was every week.
No, it's not every week.
I figured, go ahead.
Anyways, so but my PR on bench was 115 for the longest. And then me and Emily came in here last week and I tried to get 120, could not get it, it was not moving. Barely got 115 last week, and then came in here and got 120. And I tried for 125 just for kicks and giggles.
They gonna see it.
But if I would've got it, it wouldn't have counted anyways because my butt came up pretty bad, but I mean, it was almost up there, but I'm really satisfied. Why are we down here?
It's right on your face.
I'm really satisfied with 120. And Emily got 140.
Yeah, if she keeps on, I'm gonna have to do something different.
She's about to
catch up to me on the bench.
I'm gonna start doing that pose where the girls go like, whatever. You know what I'm talking about?
No. I've never seen that pose before.
The girls on TikTok.
I'm all right. Well, she did good. I did okay. I got 275 for two on the close grip. Yeah, I just got a couple reps of hundreds on the dumbbell press, so it's been pretty successful. Feel good, not hurting. So. All right, guys, that's going to wrap up the chest workout today. While I'm thinking about it, that pre-workout, no good. I only took half a scoop, and like halfway through the workout, my stomach started hurting. Not too bad, but it was just uncomfortable feeling. So I probably won't take that pre-workout again. I like my old Hyde pre-workout, simple, and it's cheap, and it works good. But I did really good on the bench press today. I was surprised I got 275 for two with the close grip. It's been a while since I've done that heavy close grip. I had the sleeves on, but it's still pretty good. Got 225 for a good amount of reps, and then I did some good volume sets of 185. I pushed really hard towards the end with the incline Smith machine bench. Got a really good pump. Felt really good. I always got to push yourself. And today I really pushed hard. And when I felt like when I normally quit in a set, I kept going 3 or 4 reps and really pushed as hard as I could, especially on my triceps somewhere I didn't record. And I could really feel the burn in the pump. So it was really good. But I'm about to go in here and eat my egg whites and Lucky Charms. But if you don't know about those, you can see what that's about in the last video. But it's been a pretty good day. About to call it a day, call it a night, get some rest, get my food in. Please like and subscribe. Let's reach that 200 subscriber goal. I really appreciate y'all watching. I got more videos to come. I'm trying to upload regularly. So thank y'all. We'll see y'all in the next video.